Elon Musk taught himself how to code at the age 10. By the age 12, he sold his first game called Blaster for $500. The game was about shooting at enemy spaceships carrying hydrogen bombs. The game was written in BASIC, but you can still play an HTML version of it in your browser, and I'll leave the link to it at the end of this video. Millions of people are learning to code today, but the way Musk taught himself how to code wasn't by going to college or taking coding courses. Instead, he had found a secret way to learn to code much more quickly and efficiently. In today's video, we are going to uncover his secret to learn to code quickly and efficiently and see if we are all learning the coding the wrong way. What's up everybody, Sadia Khaf here. I'm an electrical engineer doing a PhD in machine learning, and on this channel we talk a lot about doing things like an engineer, learning things more efficiently. So if that's something that interests you, then consider subscribing. Alright, so let's talk about the five things he did to learn to code as quickly and efficiently as possible. He optimized for output rather than learning itself. So no to courses, yes to books. No to syntax, yes to projects, and yes to flowcharts. He did not take any coding courses. Granted, he was 10 and taking college courses at the age 10 wasn't really much of an option, but also it's not really the quickest and most efficient way to learn how to code. He taught himself how to code by himself. Later in life, he did take some programming courses. He enrolled himself, but by that time, he had already learned the valuable skills that he needed to do coding by himself. And he found out that he was smarter than his teachers anyway, so he dropped out. He didn't finish his coding courses. What he did do was using books. He ordered some coding books for learning how to code in BASIC and taught himself through those books. And the benefit of using books for learning to code is you don't have to follow the entire sequence from beginning to the end and spend 6 months. Even using books, the other coders were normally spending 6 months to a year to go through the entire books, but he flipped through the books in a couple of days and started coding right away because he had found that opening a book and searching for the relevant information was much more quick and much efficient way to learn to code than going through the entire book from beginning to the end. The third thing he did was starting with a project. So he wasn't just going through books from beginning to the end to just learn coding. He already had a project in mind that he wanted to build. He wanted to build this game called Blaster. So he was only learning the skills that he needed to build that particular project, which made learning unnecessary things, well, unnecessary. He was only learning things that he needed to build this particular project, which made his coding process much more quick than the traditional coding streams where you go through these courses and these books from beginning to end, you learn the syntax, you learn all these things, which you don't necessarily use in each and every project that you're using. Also, he made syntax somewhat irrelevant for him. He took the lessons learned through his coding experience with him throughout his life, and later he became proficient in more languages like C, Perl, Python, ML Stacks, a couple of other languages. Not many people know this, but I recently found out that he has written some libraries for OpenAI's GPT-2 himself. He is a coder, he's a proficient coder. Now this tip number 5 is from me, but I'm pretty sure he would agree with me. He probably made a lot of flowcharts for his process. And this is a mistake a lot of beginner coders make today. They don't make flowcharts. A lot of students who are trying to learn to code today try to code directly into their compilers without developing the logic completely in their brain and then putting it onto a paper in the form of a flowchart or an algorithm or something that you can visually see in front of you. So he would probably agree with me on this, on his process. That you need to make some flowcharts, you need to put your mental process on a paper in a visual form in front of you before you try to code it into a compiler. So where is this Blaster game that he created at the age 10 if you want to play this game today? Well, you can find it at the link called blaster-1984.appspot.com. I will also link it in the description so you can just click it and go play this game that Elon Musk created. Did you know that you don't even need to know how to code in a particular language to be able to start coding in it? Don't believe me? I taught my friend how to code in Java in 30 minutes But I don't know any Java myself. If you're interested in knowing how I did that, I will link the video to the end. See you next time!